Deputy Minister of Information Broadcasting. My special thanks for joining us tonight to His Excellency Mohammed Ghulam Khan Sari, Federal Minister for Railways, His Excellency His Excellency Sayed Fakhar Imam, Minister for National Security and Research. Dear guests, 30 years ago, our people of Kazakhstan, who are claimed, gained long-winded independence after the breakup of the Soviet Union, started their uneasy and thorny nation-building journey, and now came to see what they have achieved so far. It is to be stressed that gaining of independence by Kazakhstan in late 1991 was not whatsoever a gift, was something taken as haphazard. Independence was an outmost outcome of the struggle for independence and sovereignty, led by generations of our ancestors who heavily sacrificed their lives on the path of that fierce and ruthless struggle. This memory is exactly what makes our independence sacrifice for people of Kazakhstan today, and there is no power to undo it. At present, independence-inspired achievements of Kazakhstan make our nation proud and optimistic with respect to the future, no matter how challengeable it might be in confronting us. This attitude rests upon strong awareness that our country, located in the very heart of the Eurasian landmark, has proved to be successful in many ways in the era of independence. In brief, it is to say that people of Kazakhstan managed to build up a strong and viable state with united and cohesive society, which is highly educated and ready for global competitive environment. Our people are indeed those who are the biggest asset of Kazakhstan, and it's fit to be an integral part of this competitive environment. This all has been achieved thanks to tireless vision and skillful leadership of the first president of Kazakhstan and leader of nation, Nursultan Nazarbayev, whose unique political legacy is safe and being developed by the incumbent president of Kazakhstan, Kasym-Jomart Tokayev. Excellencies, colleagues, as you all might have noticed, a tangible part of this reception is displayed as the exhibition arranged by the embassy in close collaboration
with the pioneers,
which is involved in activities related to providing assistance.
आप लोग तो टाइकॉन है, आप लोग तो टाइकॉन है, बाकी तो नए नए हैं।
That was the reason behind the embassy decision to bring this exhibition here, which is consisting of art pieces crafted by special children and their students under the patronage of the Rotary Club Islamabad. We see growing attention to needs of special children and youth as essential part of activities of the embassy and manifestation of our social responsibility. This is
something
that the embassy will keep collaborating with Pakistani charity-related organizations in endeavor to enhance people-to-people contact between our brotherly countries. This event is also a great opportunity to me to say a few words about Kazakhstan's brotherly relations with Pakistan, which was among the first countries recognized our sovereignty in December 1991. That recognition was shortly followed by the visit of the then president of Kazakhstan, Nursultan Nazarbayev, to Pakistan in February 1992, an establishment of diplomatic relations between our countries. Since then, we have no any obstacles to develop our bilateral cooperation and interaction. Next year, Kazakhstan and Pakistan are going to mark the 30th anniversary of establishment of the diplomatic relations, and I strongly believe that this milestone would provide an extra incentive for Kazakh-Pakistan relations to enhance the business to come. It is the time to open a brand new chapter in the modern history of our bilateral relations and revive our fraternal ties. It is the time to join our efforts and make our region prosperous, successful, and competitive. And the main problem is, if not us, if not now, when? Long live Kazakhstan, long live Kazakhstan, Pakistan, friendship, Pakistan, Kazakhstan, Kazakhstan. Thank you so much for your attention.
Thank you very much, Excellency. Now, His Excellency, Bawab Hussein Chaudhry, Federal Minister of Information and Broadcasting of Pakistan and the chief guest of the event. It's kindly requested to proceed here and say a few words on this occasion.
Excellency Ambassador Jaizan Christopher Hedley, Ambassador of Australia, Indian friends, speeches are usually boring, but unfortunately without speech we will never know why we're here. It's more of an advice, you know, that is difficult to implement on myself as well. Today is obviously an auspicious occasion. We are here to celebrate the 30th Independence Day and the National Day of Kazakhstan. And the ambassador here, Jaizan Christopher, is very popular ambassador, and we can see that so many people turned up today. Pakistan was probably one of the very few countries, of those few countries that actually recognized Kazakhstan very early, and we established diplomatic relationships back in 1992. So this shows the kind of love, affection and the consideration that people of Pakistan has for the people of Kazakhstan. I would like to convey to Your Excellency and through you to the government and friendly people of Kazakhstan warmest congratulations on my own behalf and on behalf of the government of Pakistan. Our two countries would also celebrate today. We are also celebrating the 30th anniversary of establishment of diplomatic relationships next year, because in 1991, Pakistan got independence and we got a diplomatic relationship in 1992. Pakistan highly values its close and potential relationship with Kazakhstan based on common faith, historic and cultural linkages. There are manifested in tremendous good faith, existed in official and public level.